Welcome to all of the police. A kind welcome to everybody to this meeting of the cabinet. I'm going to start by asking us please to stand for a bit of silence if we're on the lap. Thank you. Pleased that we are getting a lot of schemes away and deliver our capital programme, and as the report has set out, we've today we spent $9.8 million the month before, we've nearly got half the financial year gone. So again, we need to continue the work to make sure that we as much as we can deliver that capital programme. So I'm simply going to ask you to look at our recommendations in section 18, to note the spend from four, and the cabinet is asked to paragraph 18 to re-revise capital programme of $60.5 million and amend the capital programme to include the flood risk management works funded by a grant that's referred to in paragraph 3.28 of that report. So can we agree those recommendations? Thank you very much. Okay, that takes us on to item 5, which is the statement of accounts for 2013-14. Now, clearly, as the report sets out, the Constitution allocates responsibility for the approval of these accounts to Audit and Risk Management Committee, which they looked at their meeting in June. I think that there are just a couple of things I'd like to highlight, which I think are very positive and very encouraging. If you look at 2.6, paragraph 2.6 in the report, the auditor's report opinion identified that all five areas of assessment were rated as green, which is very encouraging. Paragraph 2.8, we've had an excellent report on our value for money statement by Grant Thornton, which again is very encouraging, and that statement said that the council was making significant progress in achieving value for money, which is heartening. And we've also got a very positive annual governance statement we're going to come to on the agenda. But I think all of those issues just show how far we've moved forward actually in the last year, which is really encouraging. And again, thanks to all the officers who have worked really hard to return our financial situation on the ground. So with those comments, I'm simply going to move recommendation 13.1, that we note the statement of accounts 2013-14, the Grant Thornton audit findings report, the value for money report, and that progress on delivering the actions identified in the value for money report, the value for money report be monitored by the Audit and Risk Management Committee going forward. So can we agree those recommendations? Okay, thank you. And that then takes us on to item 6, which is the annual governance statement for 2013-14. And Catherine's going to take us through that. Anna.
Yes, thanks, Chair. I'm going to start off by echoing your thanks to all the officers and all the departments across the council for all the hard work that's been done, because this is really a fantastic and new story. The open government statement says that in terms of our strategic financial planning, in terms of our strategic financial governance and control, that we have made significant progress. And importantly, we have a new contract in all areas of our finances, Chair. And this is really, we are functioning as an old and functional council in all of these areas, and it really has moved forward. So, really, Chair, thanks are due to everybody involved. The annual government statement 13-14 is for approval, and I hope Catherine will approve it. Thank you very much.
Yeah, okay, thanks, Anne. Yeah, a very encouraging, I think, report here. All probably what you've said, Anne, but all the key kind of challenges that we had around our corporate governance, our culture change, our financial position, and the work that we're doing to be open and transparent is a really, really positive report, and the work that we're doing to involve all elected members in a discussion about the future of this council. So I would echo those comments. It is feels like a totally kind of change in place from not so long ago. So really thanks go to everyone involved in this excellent report. So can we approve that annual governance statement? I agree. Yeah, thank you very much. Right, on to adult social care and public health. Item 7 is the better care fund
Chris? Thank you, Chair. There was some misreports as the supervisor and the data cabinet with regards to the Medicaid and the submission put together on behalf of Wirral Council and Wirral Communication Commission Group. It gives a massive opportunity for health and social care to work together to improve quality and to get better value for money at a local level. I would particularly like to thank Jackie Evans from DAS and Sarah Quinn from the CCG for the huge amount of work they put into this report. The better care funding is opportunity and risk in relation to performance related elements of the funds. And the element of a little over 3 million, as shown in section 2.2, that accounts for this with 605,000. And we are expecting an official response to the application from NHS England towards the end of this month. So this is just a note to, after it's been approved by the Health and Wellbeing Board.
Right, okay, so yes, that's recommendation. Better care fund final resubmission approved at Health and Wellbeing Board is noted. So can we note that? Oh, sorry, Bernie. So personal interest. Okay, so can we register that council
meeting?
Okay, so can we do that recommendation? Thank you very much. On to Children and Family Services, on item which is item 8, child sexual exploitation. Tony.
Thank you, Chair. This report is written following the inquiry into the Rotherham Metropolitan Borough Council by Professor Alexis Jay, which was published in August 2014. The report estimates that 1,400 children were sexually exploited in Rotherham between 1997 and 2013. Professor Jay's report described the level of abuse as appalling. Says it included a rape of girls as young as 11 by large numbers of male perpetrators. Professor Jay's report made 15 recommendations, which include undertaking and reviewing risk assessments for vulnerable children, protecting children who are looked after, particularly those placed out of borrow, those likely to be exposed to CSE, local authorities to ensure outreach work is available to young people who might not access services, ensuring responses to CSE are properly resourced and communicated, agencies working together to respond to CSE, including ensuring long-term and therapeutic support is available to victims, and engagement between authorities and minority ethnic communities. The current position in World Council Chair is this: in Wirral, prevention of child sexual exploitation is a priority action area for the Safeguarding Board. All activities currently being reviewed in the light of the Jay report. Local plans already in place include the following: the multi-agency strategic child sexual exploitation subgroup of the Safeguarding Board has been in place since 2012. Prior to this, there was a group focusing on young runaways and children subject to sexual exploitation. Monthly multi-agency meetings now take place to consider children in the area at risk of child sexual exploitation. Meetings are chaired by the police. Between 15 and 30 children are usually considered at each meeting, which is to share information and intelligence and make sure good plans to ensure safety are in place when verified. The work across Merseyside is governed by a protocol which has been in place since May 2014. Right, what actions have been developed in response to the Rotherham inquiry? Right, following an assessment of plans currently in place, the actions which are being implemented or have been implemented include Chelsea's Choice, a theatrical production to raise awareness of child sexual exploitation, will be delivered from different venues in Wirral this autumn. Meetings will take place this autumn with head teachers of primary and secondary schools raise the profile of child sexual exploitation. Both these groups are key professionals and separately young people who take place to understand how well they are working together to meet children and young people's needs and how they make improvements. Systems for improved intelligence gathering and analysis have been put in place to ensure we are tackling issues in the most effective way. Case file audits will be undertaken, including current cases and cases where there have previously been concerns in relation to CSE. There will also be a focus on children looked after who are faced out of Ireland. A meeting of the three party leaders is scheduled to take place at the end of October 2014 to discuss the findings of the J report and response in Wirral. Following this, regular meetings of the safeguarding reference group will be scheduled to ensure clear political oversight. Also, clear training for members on child sexual exploitation is also being developed in November. Also been delivered in November 2014. Engaging community groups such as taxi drivers and nighttime economy workers to identify and offer support to vulnerable young people is already taking place, with further work scheduled. Finally, improved engagement of minority ethnic communities through community leaders and the Minority Ethnic Achievement Service will be developed and agreed included more specifically in the action plan. So that's where we are, Chair, at the moment. Can I just make a few sort of individual comments? I mean, as someone who's sort of lived through this over the last sort of 20 or 25 years, there has been a lot of legislation, and certainly I noticed this when I was working, in the public service, and I look back over the last couple of days, and some of the acts that were enacted, for example, is first of all the Children's Act in 1989, and then we had the Department of Education and Employment Act in 1995, followed by the Department of Health Act in 1995, 2000.